What a waste, another day, another good one dying. But I know that the world will change the day we know we're all the same.
James Taylor would combine Brazilian, like almost Antonio Carlos Jobim vibes, like Stan Getz and Gilberto, all into pop music. And I was like, why can't I? If I were never an artist, this is what I was thinking when I was a weird 11-year-old, what would I do if I combined jazz and pop music together? So he's a huge inspiration to me, so I was very happy to work with him on this album. And we went to Conway Recording Studios, which is in Hollywood off St. Andrews, and I just kind of was pinching myself. I'm like, I can't believe I'm here recording with James Taylor. It's truly, truly incredible, and I think really tied the album together.
Change is a very special record because it wasn't originally written for this, but it came about with Ross Golan and I and Johan Carlson. And we were writing something and it was okay. And then we left the studio for an hour and came back and I just started playing on the piano. Some like soulful Al Green kind of thing. It really molded itself into being dedicated to everyone who participated in March for Our Lives and everyone at Parkland School, and just how there has to be an overall change in this world.
Yeah. Maybe I'ma get a little anxious, maybe I'ma get a little shy, cause everybody's trying to be famous, and I'm just trying to find a place to hide.
So The Way I Am started off with this little guitar line.
Maybe I'ma get a little anxious.
Because I loved listening to System of a Down, and I always loved the song Violent Pornography. They're like, and the one that went, wake up, tango, na 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 na. When I heard that melody in my head, I knew that I wanted the song to be about myself. I was looking at the album, I said to myself, wow, I don't really have any songs about myself. I have a lot of things about other people, but not about myself, so I thought it'd be appropriate to start the album off in that way.
Girl, if you leave me now.
Boys to Men, you know,
can we all act
like great, great chord changes, really beefy chord changes that I always wanted to put in my pop music. We worked remotely, they recorded the vocals in Vegas. And I had that song already written with 400 vocal takes, 400 stacks of vocals.
Leave me now.
And it's just colors and colors, and this is the fun part.
Baby, if you leave me now.
That would take like hundreds of people to replicate that live in a live setting. But when I made the song with Tobias Gesso Jr., who writes for Adele and a lot of other great people, we wanted to make an all a cappella record with a heavy nod to Boys to Men, and my vocal teacher Rob Stevenson ended up sending the song to them, and they freaked out, loved it, and then they put their vocal on it, and then a week later I find that I have a record with Boys to Men.
If you give it up, it's just one.